The bigger your low speed motor is, the more air that it takes to drive it. Hey guys, it's Jason from the Dental Equipment Repair Channel. Today, I want to go ahead and bring you a little bonus episode of some insights that I'm actually getting right now as I work. Now, usually when I make these videos, I have an idea about what I'm going to find. And usually I try to share information that is things that I've learned along the way that I have previously learned. But today I was actually doing some work with a continuing education course that I've been working on, and I was actually testing hand pieces. And specifically what I was trying to do here was demonstrate that when the compressor PSI is, it should be running between about 85 and 105, like 100, 105, 110, 115, something like that, but that it should never drop down below 80. And along the course of the testing, I was able to just generate some data so that it could be, you know, seeing how the compressor is related to the delivery unit gauges, and that even the handpiece can be negatively affected by low pressure. So, I got to this point where I was like actually kind of curious, and it occurred to me that I actually have test equipment to verify the cubic feet of air per minute for nitrous equipment. And so that got me thinking, and I thought, you know, I always tell people that dental handpieces are 2 CFM to 3. I've always said that the high-speed handpieces are 2 CFM, low-speed handpieces are 3, and size your compressor based on that, simultaneous usage. So guys, one of the things that we want to go ahead and cover first is exactly what is CFM. CFM is cubic feet of air per minute, and this is the way that you understand the amount of air that it takes to drive a handpiece. Inside of a handpiece, there is a little fan. It's almost like a windmill. And what happens is air blows on one side of the windmill and causes the windmill to spin. And then on the other side, the air is ejected out the other side. So you can see on the bottom of this handpiece, there's two ports. And the little big, which is gonna be on this side over here, okay, the little big is going to be your air coming in. So that's going to be right there. And then your air coming out is going to be right over here. Okay. And so those are the two ports where air comes in and out of. And CFM is cubic feet of air per minute that's going in and out of this handpiece. And this is how you understand how the sizing of your compressor relates to the amount of dentistry you're trying to do. Because every compressor is rated at a certain amount of CFM in order to operate. Well, I have this CFM checker. It's an airflow tester. It tests in this measurement called standard cubic liters of air per minute. And so I was actually able to go and I did a little bit of a conversion here. And so this is the conversion for that. And so I have everything here from 20 all the way down to 50. And you can see 20 is 0.7 CFM, and then 50 is 1.7 CFM. And when I was doing this testing, I was fully expecting everything to fall within the range of what I had been previously telling people they would be. And so that wasn't at all what happened. I ran the handpieces and they actually came in a lot lower, which is interesting because dental compressors are rated at CFMs Like an Airstar 50 would be at like, I think like 10 or 11 CFM. An Airstar 22 would be like half that. Tech West, an ACO 4D2 would be about 11 CFM. And so an ACO 6T2, which is a triple head, would be at about, I think, 15 or 16 CFM. And so these compressor ratings directly translate to how much dentistry they can do. And so it's kind of a long way of getting to the point of where I say, I hooked up the handpieces to this tester, and they didn't behave how I expected. So I want to go ahead and maybe run through a couple handpieces with you and see if we can come up to maybe kind of a new rule of thumb. Because I always try to do the best that I can to share information with my clients so that they can make smart purchasing decisions. But if handpiece CFMs are significantly lower than I've expected, then that means that they don't need quite as big of a compressor as I had previously been taught. And so that's what I'm going to try to show here today. So now that we've covered the basics of CFM and what ports the air comes in and out of on dental handpieces, let's go ahead and get to the testing. All right, so for our test, the main piece of equipment we're going to be using is this flow meter. And this flow meter, it's a mass flow meter, and I actually got this for my nitrous oxide testing. And so this is standard liters of air per minute. And the way that it works is you basically flow air from one side to the other on the direction of the arrow. And this actually measures the flow. So I have this hooked up to the exhaust of channel one because when we go to run the handpiece, I have this handpiece right here. Okay. When I run this handpiece is actually, the exhaust is actually hooked up to this line here and through the mass flow meter. So what will happen is as I push this pedal, and then we'll get a reading. Okay? And so as we push on that, we're stabilizing out at about 47 or 48 standard liters of air per minute. So we're 48. Okay, so 48. So we're going to go ahead and go here on our chart. And 48, we're at 1.6. So 1.6 CFM for this Profi motor is a lot less than what I have assumed it to be. And so because previously I would have said that this Profi motor takes about 3 CFM, because that is what I was told. So we're gonna go ahead and run through a few different hand pieces, and we're just gonna see what are the CFMs, and then we'll look at them all at the end and see if we can draw any conclusions about CFMs, and then maybe I'll come up with a different rule of thumb to share with doctors as I am helping them make equipment purchasing decisions. So let's get to it. All right, this is the Patterson EX100. All right, that's about 42 standard liters of air per minute. That's roughly 1.4 CFM. Next is a trusty Star Titan motor. Okay, Star Titan. Okay, 29. Next is going to be the Cavo Profi Whiz. These are all low speeds. Okay, that's 36. Next up, we have a Bays. Maxo motor, M20A. It's about 40. Next up is a micro PHP no loop. Okay, 40. All right, so now we'll start doing some high-speed hand pieces. First hand piece we'll do is a Midwest Traditions. Okay, that's 20, almost 25, 24. We've got a big Cavo here, a big blaster. This one's a Cavo Super Torque, 625C. Okay, 30. Next, we've got this, it's a Precision Torque, old manual handpiece. Ooh! That burr. Ooh! Man. Oh, wow, that's howler. 23. Next handpiece is going to be a Lars. 577. Okay, 32. All right, and then this one is a little Star 430. This one's not a swivel, it's an old timer, but just a little Star 430. Let's see what that's gonna be. Climbing to 34. Well, guys, that was really interesting. So by using the standard liters per minute flow meter, that gave us some very interesting data. And I will tell you, I learned something today because for the most part, I learned that dental handpieces, low or high speed, use significantly less CFM than I originally understood. And since I actually used a tester, I can believe that overall, based on what I've tested, these handpieces, they do use less air, which will affect the story that I tell doctors when they go to buy dental equipment. And I'm kind of tickled here. So let's go ahead and review our results here, because there were a couple things that I wanted to point out. So we'll start with the basically the lowest air usage handpiece was this little precision torque here. I think this is a Lars handpiece, and this one was a 0.8 CFM. And the next was a Midwest Traditions at also 0.8. And then next was this Cavo Super Torque. What's interesting about all of these handpieces is all three of these handpieces are manual chucks. So that was a very interesting thing to understand with regard to these, that the manual chucks used, for the most part, less air than their quick chuck brethren. Now, next was at 1 CFM was a basically the Star Titan, which this is the lowest air using low speed, which is interesting. Right after it was the Lars, which was here, the 557, which is at 1.13. I want a little more, I think I just felt a little froggy there, put in the 1.13. Next up is the Star 430, and that was at 1.2. Now, I just want to stop here and say it's really interesting because the Star is is the only handpiece, the high speed actually takes more air than the low speed, which is pretty interesting. That is interesting because I wouldn't have guessed that a low speed handpiece would take more than a high speed would take more than a low speed. And they're both right pretty close to one. Now, as we start getting up to the Profi motors here, this Cavo, which is a real fancy Profi Wiz 181P, was there at 1.2 CFM. And then this large Patterson EX100 was at 1.4 CFM. This Bays motor, which is also pretty heavy, was at 1.4. And then this other one, which is pretty heavy, which is a Micro PHP, was at 1.4. And then the one that used the most CFMs was this Acclean by Henry Schein. And that's a 1.6 CFM. And I think if I was to just kind of step back and try to understand what this is telling us, I think it's telling us that if you have a manual chuck, like a chuck with a key, you're probably going to use less CFM. It's going to tell us that with Star, that low speed uses less air than the high speed, which is interesting. And then as we get this direction, I think the bigger your low speed motor is, the more air that it takes to drive it, because I think there's kind of a more air needed. But the thing that I want you to pay attention to is the lowest air is at 0.8, but most everything is between 1 and 1.6 CFM, which is really interesting. So maybe on the average, 1.5 CFM is probably a very accurate way to size air compressors. All right, guys. So the takeaway on this is that I am learning new information about something I've been doing a long time. And I think that that is part of life. Life is sometimes doing things a certain way for a long time and then coming to realize that maybe there's new information available. And so in this situation with dental handpieces, I'm going to go ahead and accept reality that dental handpieces don't take as much air as I once thought they did. So as a rule of thumb, I plan on sharing that based on my testing, an average of 1.5 CFM per handpiece, period, is probably a relatively good way to size a compressor. And what this will mean is that no matter how many handpieces are running or what they are, we'll just say 1.5 per handpiece, because since the highest handpiece that we ran was 1.6, any number of handpieces are probably going to fall under that. And if we happen to find a handpiece that's closer to 2, a little bit higher, the law of averages will probably even that out. So hopefully this was interesting for you. This is something I'm really excited to share. I think I just heard it somewhere that low speed handpieces were 3 CFM and high speeds were 2. And as we can tell with our tester, that is not true. So now you can be empowered with information that'll help you understand how much CFM it really takes to power your handpieces. And thank you for spending a little bit of time today to cover this foundational information. You guys have a great day.